As you can see here, my system BIOS mode is successfully converted from legacy to UEFI BIOS mode, without any data loss.
So hello friends, it's JD here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel Technical Juned. In today's video I am going to show you, how to convert legacy to UEFI BIOS in Windows 10 without any data loss. As you know, I already created the video on, how to convert legacy BIOS to UEFI BIOS in Windows 10, and this video has helped most of my subscribers, they also give positive feedback. You can watch this video by clicking on the I button. Please make sure, you follow all the precautions before performing this operations, this is very important step, otherwise this will make your system unusable. Please take backup of your system, before performing any operations. Because older hardware does not support UEFI BIOS. Before proceeding to this video, please check does your system support UEFI BIOS mode or not. If your system does not support UEFI BIOS then don't try to convert it, otherwise your system becomes unusable. You can also refer your motherboard manufacturer website. UEFI BIOS only supported by 64-bit architecture of Windows, so please make sure your system has 64-bit OS installed. If you followed all the precautions, then you can proceed to this video. So let's get started. For your satisfaction, first I will show you my system BIOS mode, and then also show you my personal data. This step will help us to check data is formatted or not after converting legacy BIOS to UEFI BIOS. To check BIOS mode is legacy or UEFI, simply go the search, and type info in search box. Now open the system information tool, by clicking on open. As you can see here, my system BIOS mode is legacy. Close this window, and let me show you, where is my personal data is stored. As you can see, here I stored data, software and etc. Now let's move on to our video. For easy purpose, I am switching this video to screen recorded mode. To convert legacy to UEFI BIOS, we need to download the software. To download it simply open your web browser. And search for the Paragon Partition Manager Community Edition, in Google. I am also giving the direct download link of this software in this video description, you can download it from there. And open the first result, which is owned by Paragon Software. Once the page is opened, please make sure, the edition should be Community Edition, because other editions of this software are paid edition. Here we want to download the free edition, so please keep in mind. To download it, simply click on, Download for Free. Now click on Download button. Once you click on Download button, the download will start automatically. After downloading follow the next step. Now install the Partition Manager. To install the Partition Manager, navigate to the folder, where you downloaded or copied the Paragon Partition Manager. Now open the installer by double-click on the setup file. The Paragon setup is opened. Now accept the license agreement, and click on Next. Here simply click on Install. Now the setup is started, it will take some time for the installation, so please be patient. Now the Partition Manager is installed, simply click on Finish. Open the Partition Manager, by double-clicking on the desktop shortcut. Partition Manager is opening. It will take some time, so please wait. The Partition Manager is opened. As you can see here, my system partition style is MBR. Here find and select the disk, where UOS is installed. To select the disk, simply click on the disk, which you want to convert legacy to UEFI BIOS. Once you select the disk, the operations tab will be opened automatically. To convert legacy BIOS to UEFI BIOS, simply click on, Convert MBR Disk to GPT. Once you clicked on it, the dialog window will be opened like this. I again advise you, please take backup of your system for safety purpose. Once you're ready, simply click on Convert Now. Now the legacy to UEFI conversion is started, it will take a while, so don't press any key. I am not fast forwarding the video, so watch it carefully. To complete the operation, system restart is needed. Here simply click on restart the computer. Once you click on it, the system will restart automatically in some time, so please wait, don't press any key. The partition manager is performing some operations, so please be patient. Now the UEFI system is restarting, after restarting the process will continue, so don't turn off the computer or laptop, otherwise it will make your system unusable. Now the partition manager is performing some post operations, during restarting, so please don't press any key and don't turn off the system. In my case, this operation take about 50 minutes to be completed, in your case it may take some time. I am fast forwarding the video, to save the time. Now the all operations are completed, press any key when you see message like this on your system screen. When you press any key, the system will restarting automatically, so don't panic. After legacy to UEFI conversion, it will take some time for booting, so please be patient. Now the UEFI system is booted successfully, let's log in it to check the system BIOS is changed to UEFI BIOS or not. To check the BIOS mode, simply go to search, and again search for the info, and open the system information tool again. As you can see here, my system BIOS mode is converted successfully from legacy BIOS to UEFI BIOS. Now let's close this window and check our data is formatted or not. Congrats, our data is not formatted, after converting legacy to UEFI BIOS. If this video is helpful for you, then like and share this video. Also give your feedback in comment section. If this video is not work for you, then you must have to watch this video to convert legacy to UEFI BIOS. If your system does not have TPM module, and you want to install Windows 11, then you can fix it, by this video. Thanks for watching. Meet in next video.